بدل تبغى تساوي بس تبدل ladies and gentlemen it gives me a great pleasure to be part of this launching ceremony of the human development report for the year 2011 and it is also a great privilege to me to make a remark on behalf of the Ethiopian government as you might know the theme of this year's report is sustainability and equity a better future for all which addresses urgent global challenges of sustainability and equity and argues that both must be addressed together and identifies policies on the national and the global level that could spur progress towards these interlinked goals. The 2011 Human Development Report argues to jointly address the urgent global challenges of sustainability and equity. The report further goes and shows how the world's most disadvantaged people suffer and it also contends that the recent human development progress for most of the world's poor majority is to be sustained for the benefit of the future generation as well as for those living today. In this respect, the government of Ethiopia is very much aware of the relevance of sustainability and equity issues in bringing about and realizing human development. That's why the current five-year development plan, the growth and transformation plan, as well as the previous mid-term development plans have been emphasizing sustainable development in which we are working to achieve not only growth, but also growth with equity. The government is committed to make sure that the gains from development interventions are equitable and would be done so in an environmentally sustainable manner. Dear participants, since 2003 and 2004, the Ethiopian economy has shifted to a higher trajectory. This has been sustained, and during the last 5 years, overall real GDP has grown rapidly at an average of 11% per annum. This growth is complemented by a strong performance in the agriculture industry, which is construction and manufacturing, and the service sector, with an average growth rate of 8.4%, 10%, and 14.6%, respectively. During this period, across the country, health service coverage and the school enrollment at all levels improved remarkably, as human capital development also received significant attention from the Ethiopian government. At the same time, access to potable water also has also improved, and the population living below the poverty line has declined to 29% as of 2009 and 2010. By spending more than 60% of its total expenditure on poverty-oriented sectors, such as agriculture, education, health, water, and road development during the last 8 years, the government has maximized its effort and shown the highest level of dedication to bring about pro-poor economic growth and development. Invited guests, ladies and gentlemen, Ethiopia is committed to accelerating human resource development, giving due priority in its resource allocation. Through the education and the training policy, the government outlined a series of strategies to meet the objectives which are translated into actions through implementation of series of education sector development programs to improving access, relevance, quality, and equity in education. Universal access for primary education that benefits all children in the country, eliminating gender disparity and assuring relevance are the main targets with significant achievement over the last several years. The health sector implemented series of health sector development plans with a clear focus on the provision of primary health service. The health service extension program is a very effective instrument in expanding the health service to communities as it brings the service closer to the community through participatory approach and also being cost effective. Ladies and gentlemen, despite the impressive growth recorded in the past years, low level of income and saving and the productivity in the agricultural sector, limited implementation capacity, unemployment, and the narrow modern industrial sector base are the major challenges faced during this period. Ethiopia has also been exposed to weather-induced challenges. Climate change is a key emerging factor with adverse effect on the ecological, social, and economic fabric of the society. Therefore, addressing climate change has important poverty reduction, equality, and human rights dimensions. The various impacts of climate change will have a dampening effect on Ethiopia's economic growth rates and adversely affect the prospect for achieving the National Development Plan and MDG targets. To this effect, the country has chosen the path of climate resilient and green economy development in the future, and these preparations of groundworks are now being underway. The global financial and economic slowdown and the climate change are seen as threats that may hinder progress and reverse the development gains registered globally. The current status of the MDGs and their prospects until the year 2015 need therefore to be understood in this broader context. Ladies and gentlemen, it is my firm belief that, like its predecessors, the current report would be educative, informative, and path-breaking as well. In this sense, the report has made us aware of the need to think beyond the year 2015, the year which all of you know is set as a date by which the world has set itself an ambitious target of achieving the Millennium Development Goals and to make sustainability and equity as a framework for global partnership after 2015. Therefore, I would like to urge you to critically read the report and review its contents and recommendations and filter those that are relevant to the country. Debate the issue within your organizations is important within your professional circles as well. That's how we would reach consensus on the path that would positively contribute to Ethiopia's development. Finally, I would like to officially declare that the 2011 Human Development Report is officially launched, and I thank you.